You can charge that medium, and with magnet you can create arcs. You know, trying to referring to the sun that this type of.
How the magnets can actually bend the properties of light. Also, when you can get it, then you go from there into the Faraday effect, which is a bending, through a rotational property. There's so much more going on up in the atmosphere than what they tell us. These clowns want us to believe, except for the case of a Selenelian eclipse, they want us to believe that light enters and enters the atmosphere and comes in 100% straight, a la the Eratosthenes experiment, which is nonsense. But then all of a sudden, all the rules change when it comes to describing a Selenelian eclipse, right? Then it's a different story. But, it's just crazy. They're nonsense that they use. So, anyway.
And again, if you go, for example, to the moon and trying to study its surface, well, at least in the lab with electricity discharges, you can, recreate all type of the craters that we see. And of course, in the so-called standard model of based on asteroid impact that nobody ever see that, of course. Because we are not in the 4.5 million years away to, observe the creation of the moon. But again, I mean, there is so many type of crater that does have any sense being, a meteor impact. And these guys, at least, they present a theory based on observation and experiment in the lab and control environment that where you can recreate those impossible things to recreate based on an impact. And also you can see a lot of trails of electricity creation, this idea of Zeus being the god of the lighting, creating the world in so many, phenomena on nature, like a river, for example. And I mean, the mountains, valleys, collines. You can see in so many ways that it's more based on electricity than just a random speck flying around some orbital gravitational field that start to accumulate dust into our world.
Yep, but Professor Dave says, nuh-uh.